to be or not to be. That is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune,
or to take arms against a sea of troubles and by opposing,
bend them, to die,
to sleep no more,
and by a sleep to say we end the heartache,
and the thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to.
'Tis a consummation devoutly to be wished, to die, to sleep, to sleep, perchance to dream.
Aye, there's the rub. For in that sleep of death, what dreams may come when we have shuffled off this mortal coil, must give us pause.
For who would bear the whips and scorns of time, the oppressor's wrong, the proud man's contumely,
the pangs of despised love, and the spurns that patient merit of the unworthy takes, when he himself might quiet a snake with the bare barking?
Who would fardels bear, to grunt and sweat under a weary life, but that the dread of something after death,
the undiscovered country from whose bourne no traveler's returns, puzzles the way, and makes us rather bear those ills we have, and fly to others that we know not of.
Thus, conscience does make cowards of us all.
And thus, the native hue of resolution is singled over with the pale cast of thought.
And enterprises of great pitch and moment with this regard, their currents thus hurry, and lose the name of action.